Welcome back to my channel. So carnival is over, it's gone, yet I am still doing glittery eyes. I can't help it, guys. It's a curse. I can't help it. I posted this like a couple of days ago on my Snapchat and you guys seem to really like it, so I thought, you know what, I'm giving the people what they want. If they want glittery eyes, I'm gonna give it to you. So I just want to thank you guys so much for watching my channel. Thank you so much for supporting my channel and, you know, all the nice comments you guys give me. I really appreciate it. And if you wanna see how I created this gold, glittery, pinky halo eye, then stay tuned. Bye! Hey you guys! So I know it has been a hot minute since I've done like a talk through video, so I wanted to get one up for you guys today, so let's get started. I'm first gonna start off with putting on my contacts, because I'm a blind, I'm not even joking, I'm so blind, it's not even funny. And the worst thing about having acrylics is the fact that it's so hard to put on acrylics with contacts. Well, put on acrylics with contacts. Put on contacts with acrylics. But let me just pin back this mean. So I'm gonna start off with some sunscreen. I never honestly used to take on like skincare in general. I just used to be like, whatever. But like of recent, I've been reading, you know, Facebook always posts articles about like skincare and all this kind of shippiness. So I've been reading about it and, you know, your skin really does age and all these sun rays and whatevs. So I'm trying to keep like, you know, youthful skin. And once the sunscreen is kind of soaked into my skin, I'm gonna go in with my favorite moisturizer. I have literally been using this moisturizer since I was like, what, 12, 13. It's been like one of those ride or die products for me. It just really helps to keep my skin moisturized. My skin is kind of like mostly dry, but they have like their oily moments, like around my T-zone and my nose and stuff. But like, on like a normal day, it's dry. And I like to get it on my eyelids too. Like, this is so weird, but you know, just make sure those eyelids are moisturized as well. Today I'm using the Loreal Infallible Pro Matte. This is one of my absolute favorite drugstore foundations. I find like it's really comparable to maybe MAC Studio Fix Fluid with my stippling brush, and then just stipple that all over my face. Someone asked me the other day, like, what is like that one product that you would have if you were like on a deserted island. Honestly, thinking about it, I wouldn't have anything, because why am I gonna fix myself up if I'm on a deserted island? But I would probably have like foundation so that my skin would be like even. Just such like a superficial thing to say, but it's true. So once that is like on, kind of even, not too even, we're gonna go in with the Beauty Blender or the Real Techniques sponge, whatever you have, and I'm just gonna like pounce that all over my face just to really help blend in the foundation. And I feel like a Beauty Blender or Real Techniques sponge or whatever is really one of those staple products that everybody should have in their makeup repertoire. Is that the word? Repertoire. So for concealer, I'm using the LA Girl Pro Concealer, but I'm using it in the color Natural. I find it has not as much as a yellow undertone, a little bit more pink, and it's going to help to conceal those dark circles underneath my eyes a little bit better. I'm just going to go with that. Nothing too heavy, nothing too crazy. I know I say that as I put a humongous amount of concealer underneath my eyes. It's the extra in me, I can't help it. I like to go right at the sides of my nostrils. I don't know why, but they just get like red. I think it's because anybody, like when they're sick or they're sneezing, they just kind of go like this and like rub up their nose and like cause blisters and stuff. I am that person. So I just feel like there's like always red. Go right underneath my contour line. This is gonna help to sharpen up my contour later. So I'm going in with the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Toffee. I thought it was coffee. Toffee. And we're just gonna take that. I like to sweep it upwards. Never kind of sweep it downwards, because then you're gonna get in and maybe go lower than your contour and it's gonna look a hot mess. So kind of just keep it up.
Let me size a forehead. If you got a big forehead, this is the step for you.
Lastly, you also want to go on your jawline.
Especially if you have a double chin like I do, this is a really good step to help kind of conceal that double chin and hide it a little bit.
I find it's easier to blend out the contour because maybe if it's a little too harsh, you can go in and like blend the concealer into just a little bit to help. If you want your contour to be a little stronger in the front, you're kind of going to start in the front and dust backwards. If you want it to be a little more subtle in the front of it, you kind of start at the back and then go forward. So you keep the bulk of your product in the place that you want it to be the most prominent and then just kind of dust and blend the excess into the other areas. But for me, I just want to bold the entire thing, so I'm just like this. And once your contour is blended, we can go back in with the sponge and then just start to, you know, dab, dab, dab. I like using a sponge to blend in my concealer a little bit more than a brush. I just find it looks nicer. It looks a little bit more flawless. And you never want to like drag with the beauty blender either. You want to just kind of pounce it like you're beating your face, basically. Maybe that's where they get this, you know, your face is so beat because you're like literally beating your face. But you never want to like drag it like that because that's when you can kind of pull the product and make it look a little too streaky. We ain't going for streaks today, girl. I like to kind of blend the entire face together using the sibling brush again. This is just my like little trick to make sure everything looks, you know, even, because you never want to have like that sharp line where you're like, oh god, you can tell this girl did not blend it in properly. So I find this is just like a really good step to help everything look blended. And voila. So for the next step, we're gonna go in and set your face. So I find whenever you're using creams, liquids, anything like that, you always want to set it so that it doesn't move. Even if you have dry skin or especially oily skin, I find setting your face really helps ensure the longevity of your makeup. So I'm gonna go in with the Sacha Buttercup. And you guys, isn't it so funny? I talked about like how I had to mix it to make it a little lighter, and literally the next week I saw, oh my gosh, Sacha came out with like a light and everybody was tagging me in it. So I was like, they did that because of me. It's because of me. But no, I'm joking, but maybe. But I love the Sacha Buttercup. I find it works really good on all skin tones. So I'm basically setting all the places that I put the highlights and concealer. And then I'm going to use another powder to set the contoured area. So I look a little ghostly now, which I'm not going to lie. But now we're going to start to bronze up the face and add a little bit more color and dimension to our face. So I'm going in with the Maybelline Fit Me powder in the color Cappuccino. It's not very like, it's not too cool tone, and it's not like really warm either. So I'm just going to use that and dust that all over my contour areas. And I like my contour to look pretty sharp, so that's just me. If you don't like it as sharp, you know, do you, boo, do you. And to keep it looking sharp, you just want to make sure you don't go past this line here. And don't worry, if it looks too sharp now, you can always kind of blend it out later with the stippling brush so that it doesn't look like, you know, chiseled, which I don't mind. So I'm going back in with the Maybelline Fit Me powder on a small flat brush, and I'm just gonna focus it. I have these two kind of bulgy areas right here. I mean, if I could have gotten a nose job, I would have, just to get rid of that. But, you know, it's life. I have to kind of learn to live with it. And I figured out how to contour it to kind of hide it, which is good for me, and I don't gotta spend all that cash on plastic surgery. So I just kind of focus the contour right on these two kind of rounded areas to make it look as straight as possible. Yeah guys, now that the face is more or less completed, I like to go in and do the eyes, the eyebrows, and then I kind of finish off with like blush and highlight and stuff. So that's just kind of how I like to do it. So let's get started on the eyes. Alright guys, so I did one eye off camera, you know, just to save a little bit of time. So I'm going to start off with brushing out my brows, and then I'm going to fill it in with the Milani Brow Pomade in the color Brunette. I'm gonna start off with short strokes right at the bottom of my brows, filling them in at the bottom and defining it. And then once I have the shape down, I can kind of just go and fill in the top. I'm going in with my absolute favorite palette for color, and that is the Morphe 35B. I think it's perfect for, you know, makeup artists. It's perfect for people who just want to experiment with color. So I think this is definitely one that you need to get your hands on. So I'm starting off with these two colors here. I love to start off any like look with a kind of orangey base. I don't know what it is about orange, but I just like it. And I'm putting that in the crease. You just kind of dusting lightly. And it's like blend, 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 keep blending. When you think you're done blending, blend a minute again just to make sure. With this kind of tapered blending brush, and I'm going in with this color right here. It's like a bright fuchsia pink. And it's so ridiculously pigmented. So what I like to do is with a halo eye, you're going at the darker colors on the inner and outer corner. And you kind of want to smoke it out in on top the crease here. But you want to keep this area like very blank so that you can put like a bright glittery color, a highlighter color, whatever the color you want to do. So you just want to focus your brush and the colors on the inner and outer corner. The only difference with the inner corner is because you don't want to have anything too dark here. I find it makes your eyes look a little too like sunken in and dark. You want it to really just stay right on that lid area. So you want to go a little bit more precisely there so that the color doesn't like spread all the way to the top. If you catch my drift. Then I'm going to take this kind of flat shader brush and I'm going to dip it in to this color right here. And this color on top here. Tap off the excess. And we're gonna do that same thing. Focus it on the inner and outer corner. And then with whatever excess is on your brush, you don't wanna dip it back in. You're gonna start to kind of connect the inner and outer on the crease. So you're just gonna go back in front like this. I'm gonna go in with the big fluffy brush again and just blend as the step again. So it's just a matter of doing a step, blending a step, doing a step, blending a step, doing a step. Next we're gonna go in with this dense packing brush and we're gonna really focus it on this color again. And finally, once I'm satisfied with how the inner and the outer corner look, I just wanna blend out the crease a little bit with those two orangey colors. I'm just gonna do this very lightly just to help blend the colors. So now for the star of the show, we're going in with the Ambrosia Cosmetics, what is this called? The Glitter Pop Press Glitter in the color Goddess. And when I got this, I was kind of skeptical, to be honest. And then when I tried it, I was like, I have been waiting for you. Like, it's so reflective, so glittery. Like, focus, focus. Look at that. Just look at it now. Oh, I love it. I like, after using this one, I was like, yes girl, I need to get up on all these glitters now. So what I'm gonna use, I'm just using a flat synthetic brush and I'm just dipping. So it's kind of like a paste. It's not like loose glitter, it's like a pasty kind of glitter. So you just want to pick it up with the brush. So it's really reflective, really glittery. And what I'm just gonna do is I'm just gonna take it and just rub it and pat it on the eye. You first just want to rub to put the product on the skin and then you can just kind of pat around it to really get it to stay. And like, I don't even need, what do you call those, like any kind of glitter adhesive for this or anything like that. Like, it's sticking on perfectly. I used it for carnival for like some of my clients and they said that it stayed on whole entire day through sweat, through rain, through sun. So it is a thumbs up from me. So now that the glitter's on, we can kind of see where everything's gonna sit and where everything's gonna be placed. And now we can kind of intensify the colors just a little bit more. So I'm gonna go back in that palette with this dark purple color here. Dip it into my brush and really focus that. Now we're gonna add a lot of mascara and I'm using the Rimmel Sexy Curves. This is one of my new favorites. I've been using it for a couple of months now and I really like it. Now for eyelashes, you guys, I found a steal of a deal in Wonderful World this past weekend. So, you know me, just searching through the aisles, whatever, picking up my normal eyelashes, and then I saw in like the corner of my eye, $10 for these eyelashes. And I was like, but these look just like the 415s from Red Cherry. They look just like the 523s. I was like, $10 for this? Like, this is so... I picked up the entire row. I picked up like 20 of those eyelashes. Because, I mean, I was like, I think it's a Chinese in me. Had to get a good deal. So I like to apply my lashes with a tweezer. I find it's the easiest. And then what I like to do is just go and just place it on the lash. And you just kind of place... the middle, make sure that's good, secure the front, secure the back, and you know your eyelashes are all good to go. So now we're gonna work on the lower lash line, smoke it out, and I like to do the glitter on the middle as well, just to kind of give it symmetry. Go in with that pink color. And I'm focusing that on the inner and outer corner. And you want to make sure that that middle section is left blank so that you can add the glitter there as well. I'm going to go back in with this amazing glitter. And we're just going to apply that right to the middle. And then my favorite trick for making sure that the black on your waterline stays on is using a gel liner. And I'm also gonna apply it on the top just to ensure that the fake lashes and the real lashes blend together well. So we are almost done with the eyes. Now it's time to highlight the brow bone and the inner corner. So I'm using my favorite highlighting color, and that is the L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadow in the color Ice Latte. It is so gorgeous, so glittery, so pigmented. So now I'm gonna dust away any fallout that fell maybe underneath my eye. Honestly, this glitter doesn't really have any fallout, which is amazing because y'all know glitter is the herpes of makeup, but this one doesn't really have any kind of fallout. Then I'm gonna go in and bronze up my face just to really finish everything off. I'm going back in with that Fit Me bronzer in the color Cappuccino. For blush, I'm using the MAC Seduced C blush. I remember like when this I don't know what you call it, like a collection just came out. Like I went in MAC, I don't even have that kind of big set of money. And I went in MAC and I was like, yes, can I get this and this and this? And the woman was like, oh, we only have like this left. I was like, y'all didn't tell me that everybody comes and buys it out the day of. I went like the second day. But yeah, so this was like the only thing I got from that collection. But it's still like such a pretty, pretty blush. You're just gonna brush that on the apples of your cheek and swipe upwards. And then to highlight my face, I'm going in with the BH Cosmetics Wild and Radiant palette. And they're like four really pretty shades. And I'm just kind of dusting it over all of them. So you see that glow. And then I just like to do it right on top of my eyebrow here as well. Then I like to highlight down the bridge of my nose and my cupid's bow, so I'm going in with those same colors. So what I like to do as well, not to make my nose look any bigger, is I highlight mostly the top of my nose to kind of bring that forward and like kind of draw the attention away from that kind of end part here that's kind of rounded. And then just my cupid's bow as well. Then we can go on to lips. For the lips today, I wanted to go in with something kind of dark. So I'm thinking we can go in with the LA Girl matte lipstick in the color Rebel. I really, really like it. What I like to do, especially when I do a liquid lip, is I like to exfoliate my lips before and make sure I have on some kind of moisturizer, which I do. and just kind of like wiping off any excess. So yeah, exfoliating your lips before and making sure that they're moisturized is gonna really help your lips not feeling too dry and cracked. So I'm just gonna kind of your face just to kind of spread your lips out so you don't want to get them in the creases. And I'm gonna go in with the LA Girls lipstick in the color Dreamy, just on that inner corner. I say an inner corner, that on the middle, to kind of give it an ombre look. And that is more or less it. Then finally, just to really set everything, I'm going in with the Maybelline Master Fix Setting Spray. I'm just gonna set my face, make sure everything stays in place. You wanna make sure your makeup stays holdy. And yeah, so that is it. So yeah guys, this is the completed look. It's really pretty, it's really fun to do. It's not too hard to do, honestly. I think you're really only using, what, 3 or 4 colors with some glitz in the middle. So I think it's really fun. Definitely try this one out. I hope you guys enjoyed maybe me kind of talking more and it's not so like serious and down to the point. It's a little different. So if you like this kind of video, let me know and I'll know if I should do more of them. Yeah, I really like this look. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel and liking my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.